Alright, what are we playing?
Well, I wonder if Zuber's gonna join in. I have no idea. In fact, he might just have work today.
Wait, are we streaming now?
Yes, we are streaming right now, Ann. So, Ian, I have a nice fun game for you to play.
Oh boy.
It is a fantastic game. We're both streaming this as well as recording it. I'm not sure if Zuper is going to be here because, you know, he might in fact have work.
Well, we might not.
Zuper actually has a life, unlike me.
You need to get another job.
I really do need to find another job. This is pretty.
But at the same time, I kind of want to take advantage of this. I kind of want to, like, record a lot more. But then my work is being stupid. It's like not. It's not that I have a lot of work. It's just my work is being stupid.
I know.
Yesterday I came in and I swear I was on, but apparently I wasn't, and that was my fault. I'm like, okay, that was stupid. So then today, I drive halfway to work, stop at a Wawa, buy some pretzels. Figure they have veggie chips now, which is cool. And they're just like, oh nope. You don't have to come in today.
Fuck! What the hell? They called you on your way to work. They're like, yeah. No, we're good.
Generally, they usually call me beforehand. Usually, they're pretty good about that. If, like, it's really that, like, not busy. But today, they were bad about it. They called me at, like, 3:25. It's a long drive to work in, so I need a lot of time.
Hey, Bossrosslp just went live.
Oh, shit. I love that guy.
I know.
He still owes me $5,
he's such
though.
A cool guy.
He still owes me $5.
I'm playing the stream through my phone.
It sounds pretty good.
Hey, Bossrosslp just went live. Oh shit! I love that guy.
All right,
I know. He still owes me $5.
Such a cool guy.
He still owes me $5.
We're just going to confuse the fuck out of everybody, man. This is going to get really annoying.
I'm playing the stream through my phone.
It sounds pretty good.
And you can hear
I can
it.
Hear the loop. I can hear the loop.
It's just gonna keep getting quieter and quieter.
Oh my god.
Oh wait, someone's in. Oh, it's Randoms. What's up, man? We're gonna be playing the game.
Who's this Randoms dude?
He's a guy from Gunner Stream. Little does he know we're gonna play a very fantastic game, man. Are you ready for this? I don't think you're ready for this. This is just getting weird.
Yeah, this is getting distracting. I should probably turn off the stream on my phone.
Alright, Ian.
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
Let's do it.
I don't know if you're ready for this, but you better be ready for this. I made this myself.
Have you now?
Yes, I have. Oh god.
Oh no, it's a Fire Emblem hack. Please tell me it's not a Fire Emblem hack. Is it a Fire Emblem hack? I don't want to play your Fire Emblem hacks!
Wow, you really just temper tantrum my controller out of my hand.
I'm sorry. I'm not sorry, because your Fire Emblem hacks are shit. And not shit as in, like, you didn't put effort into them. They're shit as in, they do nothing but piss me off.
Pretty much. But this time, there's at least a little bit more to go for.
Oh, God. Oh, new game. Okay.
I still have to change the titles. There's a lot I still have to do, but, you know.
Okay. Okay.
No pressure, but everyone's watching.
Oh, God. Si, nada. Okay.
Yeah.
Put it in Spanish, asshole.
It's quite Spanishy. I should have changed the characters too. That would have been hilarious.
God.
Like if you hit A, it would have given you a Z. It would just be really fucking obnoxious like that.
Okay. God. All right. You know what? I'm just. This is your channel. I'm gonna stay true to your channel.
You don't have to put in my name. That's lame. Put in something stupid.
All right. Something stupid.
Something stupid. Yeah. It doesn't have to be you, but it has to be something stupid.
Okay.
Come on, Ann. This is like the easiest part. If you're failing at
you
this already.
You know, picking names is such a hard thing for me to do.
I'm very good at picking names. I make the dumbest names.
Do I have enough space? Dickwee. Close enough.
All right. Good stuff.
July? I'm pretty sure I'm a male. I could be wrong. See.
Alrighty, let us begin.
I already don't like the sound of this. Girl from the Plains. Alright. So.
I still have to change the titles, but.
Get up already. Oh, okay. That's not something you say to someone that's comatose.
Well, you know.
You've been out for a while. Alright, seems normal enough. Her hair is green.
Her hair's always been green. Oh, yeah, actually.
And her suit is orange. Ish. Orange-ish brown. It's about time you woke up. She sounds like a bitch. You look a little out of sorts. Alright. A concerning bitch. My name is Lynn. What's your name? Your name is Dickwee? Okay, got it.
Yeah, this is pretty great already. Fuck naming stuff. Oh, what the? You skipped it. God damn it, Ann.
What'd I do?
You already ruined it.
Son of a...
You already
ruined it. Are you getting it? Well, just tell me what it would've said.
No, there's way too much dialogue you missed.
I guess reset?
God damn it, Ann. How do you always do this
stuff? Should we pause the stream, then?
How do you always do this stuff?
I don't know.
No, I'll just be fast.
I was trying to speed up the text.
Yeah, you can't speed up the text. That's cheating.
Well, not speed it. Not
you
so
can,
I
like,
can skip
hold
it.
The A button if you want. See? You can do that.
Get up already. Okay.
That, because I know it goes slow. You can speed up the text later on, but you just have to hit the 2 button.
It's about time you woke up. You look a little out of sorts.
We'll do, like,
my name is Lynn. What's your name?
Yeah, you get to do
is
plans.
It perhaps Dickweed?
It's
okay,
Dickweed.
Got it. Dickweed. Yeah, I'm living here with my friend Nino. She found you in the field yesterday. Is the ground that suitable for naps? Anyway, hungry? I suppose so. Oh, that's really. I actually talk in this game.
Yes, you do.
Hey, Nino, get in here.
What
is our
guest?
Oh,
I don't know.
Dickwee is hungry. Chop chop. You can cook too, you know. I can also kick you out. Miss never pays the rent. I was worried you'd never wait.
The entire dialogue's going to be changed. Stop following
it. All right, then. I'll cook us a fish dinner tonight. Fish in the plains. Hey, Lynn, what? I think you might want to come outside. The neighbors are back. Oh, damn it. Let's go, you two dickwee. Move. Why am I an archer?
You're not an archer. Oh. You know.
Son of a... All right, let's, dickwee. Dickwee. Nobody's home. It's your fault for passing out near the home of wanted mercenaries. Never mind that, hurry up.
The story's gonna be great.
Oh, this is gonna make me so mad.
Oh, it will. No.
Oh, what can you do? I'm a tactician. Really? A strategist? Understood. Keep clear, we'll cover you. Lead on, I guess. We'll win this quickly and talk afterwards. Okay.
Tutorial is gone, by the way, so you can pretty much do whatever you want.
Okay.
I think you'll live. Oh, by the way.
See that first check? Be fine.
I'll help you out here. Too fast, fast. No auto cursor. In the color. Everyone loves green. And you win.
Not everyone likes green.
I like green. I like titles.
Do you like toils?
Toils are pretty cool. Alright, what you gonna do, man?
Are they gonna... Okay, yeah, I figured they would attack. Ow! Asshole!
You have a nice short sword, though.
So what's the advantage of a short sword?
It's good against knights.
Okay.
All... Like, there's a lot of knights in this chapter, I understand that. You see them all over the place, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, mostly in Ostia.
Doesn't Nino
spread
the blossom?
Wasn't Nino a magic person?
Yeah, she was. Yeah, she's an archer.
Okay.
You just randomly attacked?
Yeah, I mean, come on, how hard could... Wow, I should really read what he's saying.
Yeah. The bottom of the beast says, your ass is my reward tonight, but I'm not creepy or anything. Bottom, don't fly that way. Something along those lines.
Are we going to fight, or... The bottom of the beast says, stop talking.
You might be fucked here, Ann. Gonna have to get a lucky crit. Or you're gonna have to get a lucky dodge.
Yeah,
you don't need a lucky crit. You just need to dodge. I don't know why you moved this way. I said the tutorial was gone.
I guess I... Wow. Alright, I'm off to an awesome start.
You already died.
I already died.
You died in chapter
Dude, I told
one.
You I was bad at Fire Emblem.
God damn. That was funny. Yeah, you can skip this start.
God.
Unless you want to read all the beautiful dialogue yet again.
Let's not.
Oh, you can also read descriptions. They're funny, too, if you want to look at all the characters.
No.
Yes, you did. I changed everything. You don't want to make the text speed max.
Why not?
Trust me, it like kills it if you make it max. Fast is fine.
I'm going with purple window color.
Please change the text speed to fast.
Nope.
So it's not medium. And it screws it up all the high health is max. Trust me. Please? Please, sir. Change it to max.
Alright, fine.
What?
What the hell?
She's not supposed to do that. What?
What the
fuck did you do?
I don't know!
What?
Apparently, you can shoot bows and arrows at point-blank range.
Wait, what?
Apparently, her bow broke somehow.
That's strange. How did that happen?
Maybe because she's originally a magic user?
No. No. What?
I think you fucked up, Ross.
I didn't fuck up. You somehow, like, what? It didn't even do damage. That was the strangest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. I actually have no idea how you did that.
Maybe the game, like, knew it fucked up, so it corrected itself.
Well, obviously, but why did she counterattack? I don't... There's no reason for her to counterattack.
This is really confusing, Anne.
I don't know how you did that, but I'm just gonna accept it and say okay, whatever you say.
God, why does her dodging suck?
Because he's a guy with an iron sword. It's hard for her to dodge that.
I have a lightweight short sword.
Doesn't make a difference. Because a guy can carry his sword.
Yeah, heals. Heals, oh, heals, heals.
Read Bada's like description. This is funny.
Oh, I want to.
Yes, you do.
Alright. God. Bada. Boom, bada, boom, boom.
Got a button.
What do I press?
You should have to press B.
Not B? What button is it? Oh, it's A. Duh.
A bandit and a merc. He puts bread on the table.
That's all it is. Puts
bread. Oh, wait, so why are we killing this dude?
Because he's trying to kill you. And now you're going to get Nino killed.
Bottom of B says, your ass is my reward tonight. For payment, of course. I'm not a creep or anything. Bottom don't fly that way. Alright, clearly that's the wrong person talking, but whatever.
Well, Lynn just pops in because, I mean, she's right there. She's right next to him. Alright, now it looks like you're going to lose Nino. You just love killing your units really easily, Anne.
Well, let's see who he attacks.
He's clearly going to attack the person he can kill, because that's the way the AI works.
Oh, shit.
And if
give me a break.
Is on your side...
Ooh, hey!
Lucky bitch.
Okay! Yeah!
Well, there go my organs.
Is that literally what he's just said?
Yep. Alright, y'all good, Ann. Congratulations.
Congratulations? Well, that was underwhelming.
I wonder how you're going to do chapter 2. It's going to be an interesting thing to watch.
Dickwee, pass the fish. Dickwee, right? So, fish? In the plains? Nino? Yeah. What? Something
wrong? Something... I'll do Nino. It'll
make it easier. Yeah, there isn't a source of water for miles.
I like to take long walks.
Oh my god.
So pretty good, huh?
Yeah, I wouldn't expect it given the location. Well, anyway, I owe you an explanation. Well, you sure can guess why those bandits were after us. You briefly mentioned that you two were wanted mercenaries. That's right. Lynn and I make our living taking bounties and collecting, if you will.
Randoms gave me a picture. What did Randoms give me?
At least that was our life. What the hell?
It's smutty. Fucking smutty. That's pretty great.
If you could find my picture and do that, I would lose my shit laughing. Or your picture.
That is really
well
done.
Get a picture of Ross and paste it over one of the characters.
That is really well done.
What
the fuck?
That is amazing. We killed the one person no one ever thought possible. We couldn't even believe what we had done.
I want to put that in stream right now.
Marcus Ferrer Air. Ferrer's heir, Lord Alive. They killed Aliwood.
They killed
Died
Aliwood.
6 months ago. We are the ones responsible, us. Marcus Ferrer's son.
This story.
The town, two old women were gossiping over it. I've been across season recently. This is the first I've heard of it. What do you say is true? That would make us fugitives. Without a doubt. Fugitives? Right. More like cows awaiting a butcher shop.
Where's the image?
May I ask you a question? What are you going to do now? Huh? Well, now that you know, you could try to turn us in for bounty. It's somewhere over 1 million gold. You'd be set for life, dickweed. I saw you fought. Do you really believe I can make it there? You're welcome to try. I'm not that desperate. What will you do then? Leave, picture. Of course.
This is amazing.
You're really that? Okay. You're just that amazed by it.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think this is the first fan art I've ever received. It's just so beautiful. It's so beautiful. Dickweed.
I probably shouldn't have, like, named myself such an asshole name.
Oh, you'll live. Aren't you forgetting something?
A random, you've been seen while we were fighting. There was another after we halted the advance. The other fled. I can guarantee his report will include the three of us. You tricked me! Hartley, why bother tricking you? It's not our fault you collapsed in front of our safe house. I can't remember for the life of me why I collapsed.
The story is hilariously stupid.
It'll only be a matter of time before they attack again.
Come with us if you want to live. And you're gonna get the bastards that crossed us. Crossed you? We never meant to kill whoever's son.
We never meant to kill Aliwood.
We never could have imagined it would be Aliwood. He was taking an informal trip to see a friend in Ostia. Why? Why would I believe murderers like yourselves?
Hey, it's not like me.
I'm Nino, damn it.
But, Lynn. Alright, fine. You can be Nino. I can't make you believe me. Nino. I can only apologize.
This is hilariously stupid. Done. Like, beyond.
And I killed.
Beyond stupid, what I mean.
Those that were killed because of me. Both my parents and Nino's were killed. They were hung for being associates with us. Jesus Christ.
It's so deep and stupid.
Lynn.
There were more of us too. 10 other members. All of them were killed. This is so fucking morbid.
Oh. I feel the pain of our family and friends.
If we make your face like that, how could I refuse? Really? After hearing all of that shit, we joined them because of guilt and puppy dog eyes?
Pretty much.
I think you're telling the truth.
Thank you, Dickweed.
Thank you.
Nino Packfoot.
I just salted a bunch of carp this morning.
Again with the fish, huh?
Let's go, guys. We're burning daylight.
Stop trying to speak for Nino, damn it.
You're gonna blow my... Anyway, congratulations, Andy. Beat chapter prologue.
Nice. A warm wind blows
everybody's
nice on Dick.
Everybody's dead.
I really need to edit the maps. It's such a pain in the ass, though.
Okay, so who are we actually talking to now? I mean, who are these two people that we just met?
You'll see.
Prepared for hell. Okay.
Footsteps of fate.
Footsteps in the feces.
You're about to meet a familiar face, Anne.
Oh, God.
That should be enough.
God damn it!
I understand. Shall I run down the list?
Yes, thank you very much, Miss Vadia.
Right then, three horses.
Mm-hmm.
A poster of apples.
Yep.
A copy of Girls Are Loud and...
Is something wrong, m'lady?
Not so loud.
Oh, my apologies. Anyway, that leaves three flasks, three box sacks, and a cooking set. Got it. That's everything save what I can't carry. from what you can carry that leaves. One iron sword, one steel sword, and one iron and a steel bow. Oh, and an elixir. Scratch that iron bow, it's just a steel bow. I got to the processes with my supplier and get that delivered before you leave.
I can't thank you enough.
It's no problem at all.
I'm gonna go wait in the south gate, okay? My companions can handle the wait.
Pretty rude of your friends to make you carry everything.
Well,
I'm only jesting. See you in a bit.
She seems so nice. She won't get wrapped up with us too, right? Alright, time to go. Alright, your turn, Ann.
Who the hell is this?
It's Commander Eubens!
Today is a lucky one, too. I'm just too lucky, huh? To think I would find one of the Minerva mercenaries in this town. Kanas! Is there a problem? Did you see that girl just now? Alright, for Kanas, I'm just gonna sound like Jeff Goldblum. Sir, there's a little over 200 people in this square, and not to mention, it would be a bit hard. Shut up already!
Exactly.
You talk. Wow, it is Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah.
You talk way too slowly. I mean, that bitch over there with. There are three horses. That's, rather rude, sir. It's just a hunch of mine, but I might have to apologize, you know,
so
for you.
Much ad-libbing. Excuse me, miss. It's adorable.
How many fucking characters are in this chapter? I'm profoundly, you know, sorry for my commander's, comments. I in no way think the size of... I can't keep this up. Well, I never...
Living with a guilty conscience isn't very appealing.
For Elamine's sake?
Elamine.
Elamine's sake, just follow me.
Yes, sir.
So, do we pass our tape in?
I guess it's going pretty crap.
Terribly. Let's move in. I hear footsteps. Shit, this doesn't look good. I'm so sorry, guys. Well, apart from some circumstances today, I think my luck is going swimmingly.
Kanas, I don't know.
You mean her, right? Sir, these...
That girl.
Ah, well, I see. Well, then. Alright, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I see. Well, then, to you... miss, I must, apologize.
What? Me?
My lord, sometimes speaks without thinking, and, well, there you have it.
There you have it. What are you gonna do with it, Ann?
I should stop. I really need to stop.
He doesn't actually see you as big as three horses.
Oh, for the love of... What? I'm not even 80 pounds. That doesn't even make sense. Hey, that's just rude.
Wait. I didn't... Lynn, it's okay. It's not even an insult that makes sense.
No mercy. No forgiveness.
Hey, that's my line.
Yes, I quite agree. Oh, that voice. Someone's running over here.
Well, there she is.
Hello? Did you get the apples? Yeah, I have them with
Eager Dick Weed.
Oh my god, you have so much stupid small talk.
I have a large group, my lady. Well, it's a full-time job.
Okay, fuck it. Kill them. Kill them all. Oh, fuck the reward. Fuck you, Kanas. Fuck you, shop lady. Bring me their heads.
Well that was rather rude.
Kill? Kill us? My lady, aren't they? Oh my god. I'm going brain dead from reading all this shit.
Take our weapons if you need them.
Oh, I wish I brought my spear.
Hold on. Don't tell him. Really? She's you made knight. Her just a big fucking knight.
Look what she's carrying. That's the best part.
No weapons, I see.
No, you can hit A. She's carrying the weapons she claimed she was getting. She has no weapons. You have to protect her. Have fun. So how are you going to deal with this situation? So, allow me to basically explain the situation at hand. You have two knights immediately in front of your path, and they're both carrying a very specific weapon, as you'll see. It's called the Heavy Spear. That does increase damage to knights. And over on your right, you have two brigands who are immediately going to charge you, as well as Canis, who is way over there, who is also going to immediately charge you. So you actually have a couple different options. But you're going to have to be very careful in trying to get Vadia alive. Now, if you look at your nice little Nino over there, she, in fact, has the ability to deal a decent bit of damage to those knights thanks to the steel bow that you don't have equipped on her. Now, you can prioritize killing the knights first, or you can prioritize, kill the bandits first. However, you have to keep in mind that Nino is going to be targeted very easily because she can't attack from a distance. As well as the fact that Beta is going to be targeted by the knights because she's going to get absolutely destroyed by them. So you definitely have some interesting options here. And I'd like to see how you play it.
Let's hope for the best.
Nino is quite good, by the way, I will admit. Like, she gets some pretty decent stat gains, especially in speed. However, she didn't get it there, so. Lin is basically the same, but slightly a little bit buffed. Veda, I don't even know what the hell she is. She's just a knight.
I should probably just get rid of this one knight while I can. Ah, I can't even kill him.
And he will wreck your house. Even though you do extra damage to him. So, what will you do now?
What would you do for a Klondike bar?
Well, you can kill the bandit a little bit more. You have a pretty decent chance of knocking him out if you get a lucky crit, and he might just hit you on his turn.
He's not going to hit me.
On his turn, I mean, he might go for you.
Alright, well, we're both in woods, so...
Yep.
It's okay for now.
Speaking of which, woods are important for this map. Yes, exactly. You can move Vadia into the woods. Now, here's something that's interesting about Vadia. She has a health of 23, and with her defense matched up with the Heavy Spear, she can take exactly 2 hits and survive with 1 HP.
Okay.
However, the problem with that is she has to be in a forest for that to be a thing. So, good luck.
Keep her in a forest. Got it.
Basically. Nino can take a lot of abuse, especially when she's in a forest. See? Like, look, only 6 damage from a Heavy Spear. However, if she gets surrounded, that's kind of a problem. Because then she can't move. She can still snipe that one knight over there. In fact, you have it set up pretty well right here. You can kill that guy and stay in the forest. Well, you can mostly kill him anyway.
Oh, what? This isn't the guy I attacked?
Nope, you already killed the guy you attacked. He got killed on his turn. You can hurt the other knight over there. And you can actually kill him.
No, he has 9.
Yeah, but you can kill him with Lin easily, right afterward.
What if I just attack him head on with Lin?
Well then you won't be able to kill
him. Yeah. Good point. Okay.
They both do equal damage. You could iron bow him, but I wouldn't recommend that. Because then it would require Lin to take a hit before she kills. Oh, well there you go.
Okay.
That saves you some extra time.
Wow, that was only a 3% chance.
That was a lucky crit. Good shit.
Good shit.
Now you still have to be careful, because both of those idiots can reach, you see? Both of those idiots can reach the knight now. Both of them can reach Veda. So you have to set up a situation where Veda can't really be killed. And it's not hard to do. Since she doesn't actually have a lance on her, that axe wielder is not going to be very likely to hit her, pretty much. Okay. You could do that. It risks the shit out of Lin and makes it luck-based.
Worst case scenario, would they kill her in one turn?
Yes, they can easily kill her in one turn.
Well, shit.
What I would recommend is the forest. Because your chances are a lot better in the forest. Now, of course, Veda does have some interesting items on her.
She does have an elixir.
She does. And she can also trade to Nino for a Vulnerary if you don't want to waste an Elixir. Or you could just walk her onto the bush over there and potentially... Well, actually, they went after Nino. Because they're stupid. I guess because the Bandit moved first, and the Bandit wouldn't go after Beta. He...
just made room for her to attack.
Pretty much. But he dodged. Or she dodged. Keep calling him a he.
So distracting.
Yep. Alright, so you have a couple more turns before Canis arrives. Well, basically two. Before he's able to immediately cause some abuse. And I would recommend dealing with these threats before that happens. Just saying. Canis is a pretty difficult threat, so you're gonna wanna be freed up for his arrival. It puts bread on the table. Rye or pumpernickel.
Nah.
Try the iron bow. Much better.
You see, the interesting thing... Not in a bush, though. Yeah. I don't think Canis can reach me.
Yeah, Canis would have to run through a forest, which makes him have to move two spaces for one. So that means he can only reach about the forest. And that means he can't reach her. You can short sword him. However... Yeah. If you get hit twice in a row, you're basically dead.
And I'm not in a forest.
Pretty much. What you could do is you could focus your time and energy on Canis, because that person's going to focus on Veda, and have Veda instead just be like, oh, actually, that was a bad move, Anne. That was like the worst move I think you could have possibly made. Because if Canis moves first, Canis does move first. You keep being lucky, though.
Oh, maybe not. Not so lucky.
You still have that elixir, so now you just have to deal with Canis. And Canis is not impossible to deal with. Though he does hurt.
A lot.
And he's also pretty skilled, unlike most dark druids.
What will you do now? Druid?
Okay.
Much better. How will you deal?
God damn it.
He's in the forest now, so. If you think the knight is priority, then you should probably take him out. But if you think Canis is priority, you could also take him out. You have some choices here. You didn't hear
probably should have. Yeah, definitely should have used the Vulnerary.
Yep. As you can see, Nino can actually take a hit. Nino is definitely the person who is best equipped to take out Canis. See, Nino is good, isn't she? She's very useful to have alongside Lin. You're not exactly unequipped. You have a
check the chat.
Yeah, chat hasn't been moving too much. I'm watching it. Lucky, and now all you have to do is dodge the heavy spear.
Oh, fuck. Oh, come on!
You dodged the 59, you hit the 47. There
that
you
shit
go.
Happens to me all the time.
Welcome to Fire Emblem RNGN. Oh, hey, you remember,
the
Game Boy Advance reset? Alright, well, restart.
God. Okay, come on. Alright, I'm not going through this shit again.
Yeah, you don't have to go through that.
Such long dialogue.
There's a lot of dialogue, but it's just like regular Fire Emblem. There's a lot of dialogue in that, too. It takes a long time to edit the dialogue. I mean, you go through it in, 3 minutes. It takes maybe 3 hours to edit, really long parts. Well, maybe not that long, but it takes quite a long time. Editing one full chapter takes about 3 to 4 hours. If everything goes rather smoothly. Interesting strategy this time. You're going straight for the bandits first and using Nino to help.
Yeah. Sure.
This gets Nino strategy. A level early, and you get some strength, and that was a glorious level up, Anne. Unfortunately, she didn't get defense this time, but that is not too much of an issue. Interesting. What will happen now?
She's a pretty flimsy knight, actually.
Well, it's because they're using heavy spears. Heavy spears do increase damage against armors.
Why the hell did you give him a heavy spear?
Because that's the challenge of this chapter.
This is level 2. No, actually, no, it's level 1.
Yeah. It's a gimmick, as a in a way. It's to make things interesting.
Really? I get hit on a 31% chance.
To be fair, that's not that hard to hit a 31. Well, he just chopped off her foot, but she's alright. Some of the misses are hilarious when you see him. Alright, what are you gonna do now, Anne?
What would you do for a Klondike bar?
Boom, boom.
Can I kill this dude?
Steel sword is too heavy. If you want, you can save the short sword and use a bit more of the iron sword, but you don't get the crit chance that you do. Go for the short sword. Unfortunately, that guy is going to wreck your shit in.
I stand for a good chance.
You sure you want to do that?
I'm doing it.
Okay, you're going to make it luck-based. Gotcha.
Motherfucker!
And
I had it!
With these motherfucking knights on this motherfucking plane. Literally. It's a plane. Well, the plane's technically.
Wait, I can walk over my allies, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you can. I cannot imagine any conceivable way this could buff out. I can see about, like, 3 instances in which your characters die. But maybe it'll buff out. Just maybe. I'd love to see it, but I don't think it's going to happen.
It's not going to happen.
Let's see what happens.
I didn't think about this too much.
Nope.
I am so screwed.
Oh, it's definitely not going to buff out now. They can kill both Veda and Lin. I don't know who they're going to go for. They're going for Veda.
Yeah, what was I thinking? Oh my god.
Oh, you don't have to skip the, like, the end text. They actually, I changed that too, if you want to read that. It's kind of hilarious.
I'd rather not.
Are you sure? Like, when they die?
It can't be that important.
It's pretty funny sometimes.
God dang it. I just don't want to die! You know how much I hate this game. Well, not so much hate it, but you know how bad I am at it.
Yeah.
Let's move, game!
Try 3. When you really think about it, it's just 4 units that you're dealing with. As long as you can deal with them before Canis arrives, you're pretty much golden. Funny boy.
Please stop saying that. I really hate it when you say that. God, just...
Whoop.
So what possessed you to give her this color scheme?
I don't know. Just look pretty. I still need to change Veda's colors. She's supposed to be like a forest green. Because of her armor color. Yeah, no. The huge. And as such, she gets green lipstick, which makes her look like Poison Ivy.
Oh, good. Yeah, because that movie was awesome. you know, I should kill the dude with while I can.
I guess so. I mean, he was just going to kill himself anyway. Next turn, I think. I guess I'll eat later.
Interruption.
As usual.
Oh, give me a break.
It's quite possible for Vader to die this turn, however, it's unlikely. It just got a little bit likelier.
Oh, likelier.
You're good. Alright, so you've survived the turn. They're all going after Veda. Wow, that was actually a pretty lucky go. So what shall you do now? You have a couple turns before Canis arrives, too, I'd say.
What would you do?
So you have to find out a way to kill 3 units in 2 turns. Actually, that's correct.
Odds are not in my favor.
They still are. And I mean, you could leave one of the knights alive if you think she's just gonna, like, turtle next to Veda. It's not perfectly set in stone what the solution for this chapter is. It is a pretty good guess around it. It's not luck that requires the win here, but you can definitely win it with a little bit of luck.
That's how all my wins are.
Mm. Like, I've set it up in such a way where it is very possible without luck. You just have to be smart about it. Because there are situations that are set up with Beta in order to make her specifically survive. Like I said, she can take two heavy spears on a bush. So you could almost just, like, leave the knights completely alone. Because she could sit on a bush and just use elixirs. If you wanted to waste the elixir, however you want to keep the elixir, you have to be a little bit more tricky about it. But you still have vulneraries, and you don't really need an elixir this early in the game. You definitely have options.
Wait, so do, like, thicker bushes mean, like, better cover, or are they all the same?
They're all the same. The mountains over there would give you better cover if you could have a unit sit on it, which you can only have Nino or Lin sit on.
Hit!
Thank you for that. Alright, well, you're in a scary situation right now because I think Lin might die.
Oh god. Totally. God damn! Ah! No! Why do you make these?
Because they're fun. I gotta get Sam to play one of these.
Sam, it wouldn't be fun to watch Sam play, because he always wins.
Honestly, I think he'd lose a couple tries. Like, I lost a couple times. I set up in such a way where it is rather challenging, but at the same time, fun.
God.
Come for it. Here you go, m'lady.
Oh, killing this bastard right now. Killing you. You're dead. You are dying. Within this turn. God, I fucking hate you.
You keep seeing great stack growths with her.
Okay, and you... You must die!
Bye. Headshot. So what are you gonna do now?
Hide in the bushes and hope for the best.
Pretty much.
Actually, no. Hide in this bush to see if the...
Chances are better. See if the bush is... It feels luckier.
Holy shit.
Maybe the bush is luckier, Anne. Maybe it's the lucky bush.
Maybe not.
Well...
Oh, it's only one hit.
Yeah, you'll live. You see how this is set up now, though? Because he can do one damage, so you have to make sure not all three of them can hit you. See, I was pretty clever. I like to toot my own horn a little bit for this one.
Oh, I bet you do.
Also, you keep forgetting to get the steel bow from Miss Vader Lady. And without the steel bow, you're pretty much not able to take out the knights. Because Nino can take out the knights in two turns. With, like, almost no danger to herself. Because she doesn't have weapon disadvantage. She has good dodge.
She has good dodge.
Yeah. I mean, it's a heavy spear. Wait, why'd you go after him?
Because it's the fucking knights that keep killing Veda.
But why are you worried about Veda being killed?
Because I need Veda alive. I need everyone alive.
You do need everyone alive, but I don't think Veda's the one that's been, like, dying. It's mostly been Lin. In fact, you set it up in such a way where Lin is basically going to get bum-fucked unless you get two lucky dodges.
I'm just...
What's wrong?
Honestly, right now, I'm just pissing off this guy.
Pretty much. You're just firing arrows into him. I'd almost keep her low health if you think they might go after her instead of after Lin. But then you'd have to get even more lucky dodges. Ooh, lucky dodge one. Actually, scratch that. You're going to have to get three lucky dodges. Oh, wait. No, you won't. No, you won't. Because Veda's there. And so long as you don't kill the brigand... So long as you don't kill the brigand, then you should be okay. He moved for... You got lucky. I think you might actually win this turn, Anne.
Finally!
You might actually win this turn. He went after Nino, the fucking idiot. Alright, you got it, Ant. You got it. Candace is gonna move forward. Gotta figure out how to take out Mr. Other Knight, or maybe just leave him around and figure out how to deal with Candace.
So don't kill the brigand.
You can kill the brigand. I would recommend killing the brigand, actually. But I would also recommend healing Lynn.
Alright, so she has no damage on her, so let's just...
Yeah, she'll be fine. I have faith in Nino. Nino can sit in that bush and take two hits.
Easy.
No problem. Lynn can't. Lynn needs to heal. I would recommend putting her elsewhere. Like, she also has a vulnerary of her own. There you go. See? You're alright. Now you just need to make sure Veda is able to live. Make sure the brigand is relatively hurt, so he would generally kill himself on something. Well, the only person he can kill himself on is Lynn. He can't kill himself on anything else. Maybe if he trips, I don't know. That would probably kill him.
Maybe.
Really?
If he has to miss 30s, you're allowed to miss 75s.
No elixir. You're gonna have to get two lucky dodges again. Oh, well, the brigand might just kill Veda now.
Great.
In fact, I guarantee
he's gonna... Why did I have to make that stupid move? So... Okay.
Ho-ho-ho-ho. Lucky. Ba-da-ba-bum-bum.
Oh, God. Fuck you, Canis. Canis. Whatever.
I say Canis. It's probably Canas.
What will happen now, Ian?
What would you do for a Klondike Bar?
You have 3 units to your immediate situation. You have to heal Veda. That is priority number 1. Veda just almost died. You can kill Mr. Brigand.
So killing Mr. Brigand.
However, you have to understand one thing.
Wow. Come on!
That was deliciously terrible. I've never seen that. Whew, 95. Ooh, well, I think your situation just got a lot worse, Ann. Yeah. I don't know what to say about that one. But, nice little fact. Canis only does 10 damage as opposed to 11, like the knights do. And he went after Nino. Alright, Brigand's being stupid.
What's up? I can come back from this.
You can definitely come back from this. This is very plausible.
I don't think I'm lost yet.
You're not lost yet at all.
God, yeah, why can't Veda just punch the dude in the face?
Because he wields a spear. That's fine. Just takes a vulnerary usage. Makes you waste another turn. The funny thing is the boss is actually relatively simple once you get past the main rush of the chapter. I would recommend healing one. Just saying. We don't want to be here forever. The brigand is not the... Ooh.
She doesn't have any... Okay.
You can work this out, actually. I see a way that you can do this. Veda's alright. Veda is not in worry. Like, if you have those two, like, the brigand can't reach her, so she cannot die next turn. There's absolutely 0% chance of her dying. Lynn, on the other hand, can die. If you're not careful. Canis doesn't move first. He moves last. So keep that in mind. The brigand moves first, then the knight, then the Canis.
The Canis.
The Canis. You can get the brigand out right now, though. And that will not be that hard to do. However, keep in mind... Actually, no, that won't happen, because the knight will go... Yeah. Alright, I think you're actually good, Ant. Believe it or not. Because, you see, the AI is set to program to go after any units that do not have weapons first that cannot counterattack. So that means that Knight will not do the smart thing of going after Lynn, and will instead do the stupid thing of going after Veda. In other words, Canis will probably likely go after Lynn since she has the low resistance, in other words, spreading out the damage, unless he hits, which he didn't. So you're going to get Lynn hit, she will probably be fine, and you can probably do a couple iron arrows at Canis, and then you might be good to finish him off with Lynn.
Oh, God.
Except Lynn is hurt, so that would be a risk.
Knowing your luck, I'm sure you'll be fine.
Knowing my luck.
Knowing your luck.
Why do you say shit like that?
Because it's funny.
Da-da-da-da-da. What will you do now?
Only you can prevent rape!
Only you can prevent rape.
Wait,
Only you can prevent grape things.
If I take the steel bow and just give it to
Nino.
Nino with the steel bow can easily hurt the knight.
You forgot to heal.
Shit.
Well, yes, that's a GG. There isn't much you can do now. You pretty much have to hope for a miss.
But you can go after Canis. You can't crit, though, because he actually has luck. So, yeah, I would go after Canis. That's like the only thing you can do right now. Like, your chances aren't great, but he's not going to go after Nino anyway. He's going to go after Lin.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
Though, can the knight reach Lin?
I don't know.
One, two... Yes, he can. But Canis moved first. That's how.
Okay.
57.
Fingers crossed, fingers crossed! Damn it!
Lin,
this can't be. Hey, maybe this is for the best. At least now I can apologize to him. How was that funny? That wasn't funny at all.
Some of them are funny.
God! That was the most morbid shit I've ever read.
Some of them are funny. Some of them aren't. The one that comes to me that's funny is...
How many chapters of this shit do you have?
So far, I have up to chapter 2. Chapter 2 is where it really starts to get weird.
Dude, I'm leaving in 20 minutes.
You're leaving in 20 minutes?
Oh, it's gonna be 7? Damn it. I love that picture, though.
Oh, that.
Yeah.
Let's go, Dickwee. Move. It's just so beautiful. Good old Smutty.
What would you do now?
Only you can prevent rape. Blew that booty. Show me the booty. Give me that booty. I like the booty.
If she gets strength here, which she did, that
means... that was a shitty level up.
No, she still got strength, which is what you need. Now she can 2-round the knights, which is very important. It's not necessary, but it helps
a lot.
I'd recommend using the iron sword, probably. Save the short sword usage. But you can hope for a crit if you want to.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, the short sword's not totally necessary. You're probably going to get a replacement for it sooner or later. What will happen now? Zoop.
Nice going, asshole. Really?
Really?
Stab me right in the tits.
Actually, it was a little bit of an undershot there, but, you know.
Oh, but she could dodge it.
Of course. She has all that heavy armor to maneuver. She's rather trained in the art of maneuvering.
Oh, really? And Nino isn't someone who's supposed to be nimble?
It's Nino, not nimble.
I get fucking it right. Hate you.
What will you do now? Why would you use the steel sword?
I don't know.
Yeah, there's literally no reason to use the steel sword there. But, whatever. It also weighs her down, by the way. You gotta keep that in mind.
Really?
What?
Damn it.
The steel sword?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking the original Fire Emblem. Her con is not that great. Just like the steel bow weighs down, you know. Their cons are not exactly perfect. So, you have to deal with that fact. What will happen now? That was actually a rather good move to put her next to Nino so Nino didn't get stabbed in the chest again.
That's honestly not even my attention, but whatever.
Yep. Now you just have to deal with these two. You technically have another turn. If you maneuver properly, Canis won't bother you. But
yeah, but when's the last time I've maneuvered properly?
Yeah, that's true enough. I would not do that. I would just have Lynn work. You still have a full fresh night to deal with. I would not do that. Though, what you can do is use the steel bow against Mr. Knight over there. And put him in killing range for a good old Lynn.
Whatever. If only Veda had a fucking spear.
Which she doesn't. Now, here's what you can do. Check the damage that Lynn will take from Mr. Brigand over there. That's not bad, actually. He used a short sword there. There you go. And that's not bad at all. I don't think she can actually die from Mr. Knight or Mr. Brigand. Yeah, you're good.
Sup, bitch!
Alright, and I think you maneuvered properly for once. Now you just have to figure out a way where Nino won't die. Because now Nino is in range of Canis, I think.
Alright, solid level up.
Very solid level up.
Ooh, that booty. Show me the booty. Give me that booty. I like the booty.
By the way, have you noticed so far that you have all girls?
Actually, now I've noticed.
I haven't edited in guys yet. I mean, technically there's guys. Oh, well, that might be GG for Nino.
Oh.
Ooh, that's a bad jam right there. You steel bow wingy down.
I can't tend to you right now. I'm not going to let you die. But I promise I'll stay with you.
When are these funny? None of these are funny!
Holy man, this is funny.
Should I even keep going?
Yeah. Well, no. Nino's dead. You need me, though. Definitely.
Oh, my God.
Nino's, like, one of your best units.
Damn it.
My turn?
Yeah, you know what? You fucking play. God damn. I hate this game.
You just hate my game version of it. Alright, let's go.
Whoop. I suck so bad at Fire Emblem.
Alright, here's my idea for this chapter.
Oh, it's an idea? Yep. Really? You have an idea for your own level?
Yep. So, here's what I recommend. You see this bush up here? I don't know why you never moved up to this. Because now...
Bam.
Nope.
Oh.
You ready for this, Dan? Watch out, my turn goes.
I hate you.
I bring him, might just go after Nino, but that's fine.
I hate you. Dies.
He hits me with a 20, which kind of sucks. Oh well. A little bit of unluck, but it'll buff out. Hitting yourself with the ball.
Yes. In the gut.
Why?
Because I suck at Fire Emblem.
I need this punishment. I will be done.
Why can't I play Fire Emblem? Why am I so bad at it?
I don't know.
I was so pissed. I got to the very last level in the official game, and Sam beat it for me. He beat the last level before I could beat it, and I... He took my game, beat the last level, and started the game over. God damn!
How could this happen to me? I made it so far, and then the berserkers went too far. Seriously, the berserk staffs in the final level are a really big cock. Anyway. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to use an elixir, but that's fine. As long as Lynn is lucky enough to dodge a 20%, which he probably will, and he goes after Nino anyway. Perfect. Should have figured that out anyway. Alright. And this also forces Canis to have to walk a little bit extra distance, giving me extra time. Perfect. Whoop. Alright, what do we do now? Ah, I see. Here's what we'll do. Steal about him. Poke. Poke.
And that knight shall be dealt with next turn. This guy, meanwhile, is going to be able to hit me. However, he will not be able to hit me.
It's actually a tricky situation. Actually, though, not exactly in a great way right now. Though, what I could do...
Interesting.
I have an option in that. I also have an option there.
Oh, I know what I'll do. I'll move right here.
Short sword you. Good.
Why am I so bad at Fire Emblem? Why can't I just, like, figure this shit out?
I don't know. It's just one of those games. You know?
It's just one of those games that doesn't click with me.
So are you going to... Yes, you are. Alright, Lin's going to have to get a little bit lucky here. However, I think the knight will move first. And if the knight moves first, I'm fine. The knight move first, I am fine. You know, unfortunately, took a little bit of damage there, but that's fine. She'll deal with the knight next turn. You're going to hit me. I'm just going to vulnerary that off. Ooh, I got a lucky dodge. Hey. You know, just wreck this guy. And we're good with that. And she should hit both 88s, unless I get really unlucky.
I hate this game.
And thus, we are golden. And we just have Hayden's luck to deal with. Vulnerary that up. Let's play Quidditch! I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan! This person's probably gonna go after... Yeah, he's probably gonna go after Nino. Think about it. That would make more sense for him to do. Yes, he did. And he went in the bush as well. What a fucking cock. Alright, well that's actually a little bit of a problem, but I can elixir that off, so that's fine. Still in good shape. Alright. Move up there. Trade. Put the iron bow up first, so I have extra dodge, elixir me, and we're good. Alright. Now we just wait a turn. That's the best we can do, unfortunately. He's gonna go after Lin, since Lin has the worst resistance. Unfortunately, I should have positioned her in such a way where he wouldn't be able to attack him with bush, but I don't think it's really possible. And an unlucky hit.
That's fine. That's perfectly fine. Get in the bush over there, Nino, and we are golden.
Are we? Are we golden?
Probably might miss here, and if I do, that's fine. I am prepared. Ooh, that was a lucky round there. Good round. Lin can heal with the vulnerary. Regardless of whether or not she gets hit next turn, if she does get hit, then Nina's getting the kill. If he misses, then Lin is probably going to get the kill. I'll see what happens. That is a Nino kill. Fair enough. Lin has to kill the boss anyway.
She has to?
Pretty much. And bam.
Well, this isn't quite nice at all.
Lord Humans, I'm afraid the rest is up to you. Alright, all yours.
Oh, really?
You're welcome.
Watch me fuck this up.
I really, like I said, there's almost no chance. As long as you're even the least bit competent, there's actually zero way you can fuck this up. You just have to heal Lin every single one of her turns and just use the short sword, because the short sword's the only thing that can really damage him. You got a lucky Lin level up, so you should be perfectly fine. I mean, you can use Nino a little bit, but I'd recommend just going straight for Lin. Since look at Nino's level right now, whatever it is. I think it's like 3 right now she is. Lin is only, like, level 2, so Lin needs the experience anyway. Keep in mind, Yubins does have a javelin, so don't try to attack him, or don't try to move in his 1-2 range before you get into combat with him.
Gotcha.
And guess what? He drops that javelin, so...
Yay! So now Beta isn't totally useless.
Yep, but that javelin might as well be useless because it has shit accuracy. He won't move, don't worry.
Like, at all?
Nope. I could have made a move, but that would have been mean. That would have been really mean. That would have been fucking impossible and very luck-based. Because he would have blazed past Canis and basically would have came in and fucked everything up. I don't think he can do, like, any damage at all to Veda, so that's funny. Actually, you know what's interesting? What is Lin's speed right now? If Lin's speed is at least 10, you should be able to double him. Alright, so... You can check. You have to hit left or right. Alright, you're good. Now, here's the thing. Here's a strategy in Fire Emblem. It's called, I forget what it's called, but basically it's boss turtling, pretty much.
Boss turtling?
Alright, don't move her in range.
Basically, just move up to the boss, but don't attack. So if you do that, then he's forced to pretty much attack you next turn. And, if you attacked him, then he'd hit you, and then he'd hit you again on his enemy phase. So, pretty much, by doing it this way, he can only hit you on enemy phase. By the way.
Why the hell is that Balker?
Because it's not Anna anymore.
Fucking hate you.
Better, better, bam, winning, winning, will. Alright, yeah, you got this, pretty much.
You've been...
Now you can heal in your turn. With the vulnerary, and you pretty much can't do anything. See? Can't even hurt you. This is why this is perfectly fine. Chapter pretty much completed. Congratulations, Dan. You beat chapter 2, even though I technically beat it for you, but, you know.
I hate you. Hopping out.
Yeah, for the first couple tutorial chapters, you can't actually end your turn. You have to wait all your units before you're allowed. It's really stupid, I know, but just deal with it. Wham, wham. Well, that saved some time.
Okay. Lin was done with his shit.
Congratulations, Anne. There's chapter 1 down.
Really? Only that got one luck. Yeah, that was the shittiest level up ever.
Oh, well. You're fine.
Damn it all. Close one. Yeah, right? Miss Beta, are you alright? It's quite alright, actually. I'm not quite sure what's happening, though. I can explain that, you see? Alright. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Oh, here, I'll set the mood. Here's a picture I painted during the battle.
Wait, when did you find the time to paint this?
Never you mind that. See, this is Lin, and these two are getting insane. And there you are in the background, by the way.
Who?
You two were asking a lot of questions today. Anyway.
God damn it.
You aren't allowed to get rid of the picture, so that's the reason behind that. So that's our story. That's a rather relaxed outlook.
You aren't angry? I hated the little bastard. Pompous, the whole lot of them. My father was killed by Farron Noodles.
He was kind of a rascally drunk.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry. This is just fantastically stupid.
But he wasn't a deadbeat. He didn't hurt anyone when he was drunk.
And he always paid for anything he broke. Story.
No tears now.
Thank you, dears. I'm glad I could talk about this. But it sounds like you have a rougher journey than you let on, eh? Well then, try to tag along if you please.
Honestly, I don't think there was a way that could have been more...
That couldn't have been offensive.
That couldn't have been more offensive.
Hey-ho.
I don't think we have that kind of time. There isn't anyone around this time. So you'll likely never be encircled with us by the town soldiers.
Please, Miss Veda, don't throw away your shop for our foolish cause. You seem so nice, it's just...
It's okay, miss. I've worked over 10 years as a traveling merchant.
This voice acting is stupid, but it's fun.
Only the past three have I finally opened up shop to call my own. It was my life's dream, but now I've accomplished it, haven't I? It's time to work out a new goal, and I say revenge for my father!
Untimely passing sounds quite adequate. I'm sure we'll run into a Lance user. Sooner or later, anyway.
Are you sure you're a merchant, or most of them have no backbone? Alright, come along then. But we aren't waiting for you in that heavy armor. Lin, Nino, and Dickwee, right?
For formality's sake, it's a pleasure to make your company.
God damn it. What time is it? I gotta leave in like 5 minutes.
Well, that ruined. I don't know why that ruined. But anyway, she basically said something like, well, sorry, you know why in our cause, or whatever, you know why in her situation we were willing to let her go, but not in yours? Basically.
Involving innocent others. Oh, it's basically just me getting pissed again?
Not really. It's Lynn feeling sorry for herself.
Yeah. That was good.
You just wanted to let me live. I can't put my finger on why, but I believe this trip will be enlightening for us both. So I guess you're stuck with this dead weight and can't participate.
Is this dead weight coming from Ghost Trickster?
A little bit.
God damn it.
Where to next? You might set fire the moment you walk in.
I thought you said you believed in me. I do. Relax, but who's to say the church will follow suit? Point taken. Well then, we'll just have to be careful. I'm not leaving without a blessing, even if I have to force the bishop for one. Goddamn.
That kind of defeats the purpose of getting a blessing. That's like holding a store clerk at Sir Point for not remarking about the weather.
That's a terrible analogy.
Yeah. Either way, how about we just watch the rest of the story, and then, like, without playing the chapter.
With a new friend in tow, Lynn and the company set off for
a Bagonian church. Even though it's vulgar, I need to change that too.
Lynn's rigid faith, she has the Elamine's teachings have surfaced at what? What the hell?
A rather plot convenient time.
But she's religious, I swear it. So without delay, the group makes haste towards the church. Nino bickers with Lynn, byproduct of her lack of faith.
Dickweed just watches with a sword smile.
Perhaps enjoying the lighthearted air. However, the three knew such air was easily dispersed. Could the next battleground be the church?
Well, it must be, since it's alluded to. Welcome to the church, Ann.
This is the church. Vicky, everyone, here is Baggins Church. Great, now can we go? Oh, hush, it's not like you have to go in with me. Dickwee and I will go in. I'm not exactly religious either. Sorry, Lynn. I don't mean to push the mold here, but we need St. Elamine's help on this one. We've got a lot of rough challenges ahead, and prayer might just get us through it. Really?
Really?
I never would have guessed. Who would have thought a prayer would get you through hardships?
I don't think we need a 1,000-year-old dead lady's help. We'll wait over here, okay?
You two are sacrilegious, you know that? I'll be quick. Really?
It's Urk. In the flesh. Old bag, there's a lady approaching from the left. We forgot to install a side door.
I guess we just have to kill her then.
Wait, where's the progression of thought in that?
We don't have a side door, she's going to complain. She'll give us a bad review on RaiderChurch.com.
There are about 5 things wrong with that statement. We can't just kill someone because they're going to give us a bad review. Such an act will look bad on itself. Plus, we're a church. Everyone hops in the stupid shit we do like a pack of wolves.
Who's the bishop here? We kill her, she dies, and no one knows. Plus, her corpse will make a nice sacrifice. Very valuable, wouldn't you say?
Oh, for the love of... Are you sure you worship Elamine anyway?
Elamine, who's that? I thought we were worshipping Cthulhu. Cthulhu is not a god of sorts or anything.
Forget this. Fine, but Glass, make our move.
His name is Glass.
It's Glass, remember? Glass, give the sword here. Yes. Right, we should be suitably prepared, eh? Oh, but it is your old Cretan. The Mani Katai, the ultimate... All for Elamine's sake. Get out of the sheath, damn it.
Remember how I said I was forgetting something today? Vaguely. Well, I just remembered. I was going to go downtown to get some WD-40 and get old Katai there out.
And just why is the sword stuck?
I super glued it.
You know those annoying rats? They keep coming in and playing with the artifacts. Annoying little shits. That's it. You're going in timeout. You have to catch me first.
God damn it.
And this part glitches. So what you have to do... Shit. This is weird. It just glitches all the high fuck. So what you have to do... How do you do the reset button?
I honestly don't remember.
Oh, there it goes. That's weird. Like, you did it. Alright. So for this part to work, you have to, like, skip through the text. But I just wanted to read the whole text there. So. Skip.
Yep. And now it should work. So blah blah blah, get the sword here, ways nigh the always, old green mana katai, ultimate, gas, fucking sheath, remember I was getting something bigly. Well, blah blah blah, WD-40, super loaded.
Isn't it kinda like, I don't know, blasphemous to tamper with religious artifacts?
That's why this old bitch is hilarious. You'll have to catch me first.
Damn, she runs like the wind.
Stupid old Olympic sprinting hag. Miserable religion. I care nothing for you nor this life. I'll tear this altar down and kill the guy myself. You're going to make an ass of yourself, Urk. Bag, you're supposed to be in time out. Don't make me extend the cock.
What the hell? I beg your pardon, miss. Can I help you? Just wanted to inform you, there's a lot of reasons not to go into the church over there. Least of all, the fact that it's on fire. Wait, what? Oh yeah, it's burning pretty good. Those zealots in there are really weird. Someone needs to stop this. The fire festival isn't for another 8 months. Wait, so Elamine's followers actually practice lighting churches on fire? Spare me the trouble, I sorry I warned you.
No need, Lynn. You have it right here.
You guys came after all.
Well, the forest is kind of burning.
Hey, wait, who are you two?
Oh, my apologies. We're kind of tied to this chapter like glue. Quite, if we aren't here. The map basically explodes.
I see. I take it that's why Glass is just here as well.
Got it in one. We're rather useless, but try not to kill us. It's probably best we live.
Alright. Great.
Hello, Mr.
What the hell?!
Did you know the douchebag who made this hack changed the house dialogue? Be it humor, tips, or other, they've got something for everybody. Take a look.
Alright, well, I'm not playing this.
Alright, do you want to at least look at the houses?
Fine.
Oh, by the way, Stain and Kent are completely worthless.
You know, they say that the sword at the altar isn't actually a sword at all. Rumor has it anyway. No one can really confirm it, though. It's under the constant watch of the old bishop lady. However, my own son plays with it sometimes, though you shouldn't trust him. He's full of blown Really smart, aren't you, Shacklick? What? Boy proceeds to stick his fingers into his shoe. Then he jumps in and flaps his free arm. What the hell? That was just borderline retarded behavior.
Is it?
So it seems you've given two random cavaliers to. It's a really strange occurrence, it is. But it's not as if it's worthless. Nope, those cavaliers are pretty useful. Sure, they can't really attack worth much, but they die easily, and they die easily in one hit. But that aid is no joke. They can rescue your units easily. Sure, their roasts are terrible, and they can't fight, but don't forget, every unit has a use. Even the really, really bad ones. Yeah, it's taking a hit for you.
Pretty much.
Hey there, chap. I just moved near this church, but boy, it is inconvenient. There isn't a stinking side door. Well, there used to be one. However, it's been sealed over. If one wanted to get...
Oh, hey, Zuper's in.
Though, no.
He was a little late. I like church on fire.
Not to mention the siege to be angry. Heck, he might even attack you from beyond the wall. But then again, that old hag is annoying with that super glue verse. She might have already fixed the wall, making it unbreakable anyway. Guess the hills really are my only option, huh? So, was that a hint that the wall is unbreakable?
Pretty much.
God damn it.
And also that Urk will attack you if you try to hit the wall.
Great!
You see, Urk is like the hardest challenge so far in the hack.
Jeez.
He's a nice little sage, and he hits like a fucking truck.
And who's this? Oh, it's Glass.
Yep.
Glass is the boss.
Because Glass has to be the boss, otherwise the chapter forks.
Okay. Alright, God damn it, I gotta go. God.
God. Well, it's been fun, Ann. Zuper, you really did come in at a bad time. This is hilarious. Cavaliers are the best fighting class. What's his aid? I would never use something like that. Basically, what aid refers to is the ability of them to rescue. Like, you see, their con, their aid is fine. They can rescue pretty much anyone. However, their stats are so completely terrible that they will get absolutely destroyed by whatever touches them. Like, literally, I don't think it's possible for them to survive, like, any hit.
Wait, did it say they're level zero? They are level zero. They're level zero.
A worthless unit that's tied to the prologue chapters. Hates women. And look.
I heard what you said.
And then Ken is a worthless unit tied. Gets all the ladies.
Somewhat pushy, but guys like that. That is not true. A young mercenary girl, friends with Lynn, despite some bickering. Some?
Deserted. I need to change that. That one hasn't changed yet. Glass has a funny one, I think.
Eric's hired arm doesn't say much, but that's a nice break, isn't it? Thank God. A young rebellion sage of the Begonian Church hates a certain old bag.
That's basically it. So you have to watch out for Mr. Physics Staff Gerson. You gotta watch out for the fact that Earth will destroy you. Glass actually isn't a problem at all. Everyone else is a problem, though. Like, you have to deal with a couple immediate threats. This chapter is not too terrible. The only real problem is Urk. Urk is the only problem that you have to deal with. And also the physic bitch. The physic bitch is pretty annoying. You also have to deal with her. But that's the chapter.
Do you know how much I hate you right now?
Don't worry, next time we'll have extra chapters done.
Do you read? Oh my God!
Bye, Ian. Goodbye. He just beat the shit out of an exercise ball. Yeah. Either way. Oh, is it that picture again? Please be that picture again. Ian, come back. Please come back. Ian, please what? Come back. You have to see this. You have to see this.
Oh my God, it's very good. It's very good. It better be freaking good. I swear to God, if it's not worth my time, I'm going to be pissed.
Oh my God. It's me. They put your face on Earth.
Oh, that is the most brilliant thing I've seen in my entire life.
Oh my God.
All right, I'm not gonna lie, that's pretty funny.
That is pretty amazing. I need to add that too now. But either way, that is the temporary end of the stream.
I'm gonna go eat dinner. Ian's gonna go home. I'm probably gonna come back on my own. Probably something like that. That was really funny.
Oh, God damn. Ah!
Fire Emblem
is
so much fun.
I hate Fire Emblem.
Fire Emblem is just the best.
Alright. Be back in, I don't know, 30 to an hour. Somewhere around there.